Thank you, and welcome everyone to this 49th Academy about Survey Access. The feature in itself, Survey Access, is not new, but has been part of Enfield for years. What is new is that when we first introduced it, you could only configure it through the API, and we now have made the configuration possible through the interface as well. And that was the moment where he said, okay, let's have an academy and explain this to the wider audience, how this exactly works. So that is what this academy is about. This is not a very complicated feature. I expect that we will be done within half an hour today. Very short reminder about a string of spring academies that we are doing. This spring, the first three are already done. I will not repeat them anymore. If you missed them, you can find recordings on our website. Survey Access is the one we are doing now. Next week, we will end Spring Academies with a session about how to start interviews. The agenda of today. As said, this is about Survey Access. To put that Survey Access in a somewhat wider context, I will first explain a bit about Enfield domains. Then the different logins or credentials you can use to connect to an Enfield domain. We take a very short look about user roles. All of this will be more reminders than explanations. And then finally, we go to the Survey Access. I will demo that, how to configure that. And as always, we will have time for questions at the end. So to start, Enfield is organized in different domains. This means every user belongs to a domain. And as that user, you have access to one particular domain. If you have access to several domains, that means that you probably have several logins to a domain. But as a rule, everyone has access to one domain. A survey exists within one domain only. So if you have a server on one domain and you want to have that on another domain as well, you need to export that server, for instance, through the API, and then import that again in that new domain. And for both of these domains, you will need valid credentials. So there is no direct cross-domain relationship or traffic between those domains. Then logins or credentials to Enfield domains. We have two kinds of logins or credentials. Logins, what I mean there is the username and password you use to log in to your domain. As said, we have two sets of logins. One is what we call the native user. The native user is the user that you create on the domain yourself. So that is a user that is unique to that domain only. And then we have the so-called SSO, single sign-on. And the single sign-on is where you use the credentials of an other, an external program to identify yourself to Enfield. For instance, if you log into your Kantar, or if you log into your company network, you will almost certainly, once you open Outlook, immediately go to your inbox. And that means that that network login is also valid as an Outlook login. Now, the same thing could also be set up for Enfield, that once you have been logged into your company network, you can also be logged in to your Enfield domain. As far as we know, Kantar is the only one who has set this up. If you work for Kantar and you are still using a native user, Kantar wants everybody to work on the SSO. So contact Freshdesk, please, how to set this up. If you're not working for Kantar and you would like to use SSO, get in contact with us and we will figure out how to make this work on your domain. So that is the logins to Enfield. And then last thing, before we go to the Survey Access, there are also different user roles within Enfield. So once you have a login, and that login is then coupled to a user role, and that user role determines what the user can do. We have different predefined user roles. You can find them here in this link. I will open that. As you can see, we have a domain administrator. A domain administrator is more or less a limitless role. A domain administrator can do everything. It is mainly meant to, as it says, administrator your domain. Then we have a power user, a regular user. A regular user is what you would be using for your day-to-day work. A limited user only meant for the API, and then a few very specific roles like sample manager. Local domain manager here in this countdown, you can actually see what that role can do. A global domain manager, operational user, quota manager, repository manager, supervisor. This is a KP role only. Scripter, demo user, and that's it. Those are all of our use roles. We can create new ones if you have a particular need for one set of rules. Again, get in contact with us and we will see if we can create that role for you. So those are our user roles. Let's go back to our presentation. Slideshow from current slides, which it isn't doing. Okay. So user roles. So we have the domains, which is where a user logs in. We have the credentials with which a user identifies itself to the domain, and then the user role that determines what that user can do. Now, last step, and that is the actual why we are doing this academy today: the survey access. The survey access determines what a server, what a user can see, what sort of surveys a user can see, and if he can act on those surveys. That is done by creating groups. Groups don't have a meaning outside that survey access. All those groups are meant to do that you can then assign surveys to a group, and you can assign users to a group. And then those users will only see those surveys that match the groups they have been assigned to. To see the same in an overview, here, if you see, I here have three groups, A, B, and C. 15 surveys assigned to one of these three groups, and then users assigned to one or more groups. So that means survey A or survey one is assigned to group A, so only users assigned to group A will see survey one. If you look at that from a user perspective, user A is only assigned to group A, so user A sees survey 1, 2, 3, 4 and nothing else, because those are not assigned to his group. If you look at user G, user G is assigned to group C and to group B. So user G sees all surveys from 5 to 15. He doesn't see 1, 2, 3, 4 because those are assigned to group A and he is not a member of that group. To note here, as you can see, surveys can be assigned to one group and one group only. Users can be assigned to multiple groups. So this is the overview. Let's now simply go to the demo and let's take a look how you actually configure this in the Enfield Manager and what that results in. So let's switch to the Enfield Manager. I'm logging in as a DA now, first as a DA, because I will start with setting up some groups, creating a new user, and all of that requires DA, right? So that is why I am first logging in as a DA. Let's wait for the survey list to load. There it is. We have a new tab here called Groups. And if I click on Groups, you see there are already three groups created here. And as I said, this is not a new feature. You can see that here. These groups I created when this feature was first new, and that was 4 years ago. But now you can do this in the interface. So let's create a new group using the interface here. We click on Add here, and that will create a new group. I need to give that a name. I will give that Wednesday Academy. You can give it a description. That's the group for Academy. And that's it. We have now created a group. We need to save it. And here we can see our new group, Wednesday Academy, created less than a minute ago. So we have this group. We now need to make sure that there are users attached to this group and a surface. Let's start with users. So we'll go to access. This, as pointed out, is going to be the only difference between native accounts and SSO accounts. I am using a native account here. I will only be using native accounts for this demo. But if you were SSO, you would have a second tab here, which lists all of your SSO users. And if you want to assign those SSO users to a group, you will be using that tab. For now, as I said, I'm only using native accounts. So I will be doing my work here. I will create an entire new user. Let's call that Test Academy Wednesday. Wednesday Test Academy Wednesday. It's a regular user, so this is not a DA. Test user, email address, and that's it. I can save this user. Password has been generated for this user, so I will copy that. And now let's find that user to actually start assigning some groups to that user. So user will be on the second tab. So it starts with a T. Test Academy Wednesday. Let me actually note down that name so I don't forget it. Test Academy Wednesday. So that is our user. It's a regular user. And here you can see the survey groups he belongs to. As you can see, currently, he only belongs to the default group. The default group, that's a special group. That group is always here. If you create a new user, it is assigned to the default group. If you all your current surveys, if you are not using groups already, are also assigned to the default group. You cannot delete the default group. The default group will always be there. If I do not want this user to be a member of the default group, I need to actively unassign them from the default group. I do want them to be a member of the Wednesday Academy group. And to make it a little bit more interesting, let's also make them a member of the NEPO group. So these are the ones I select. Let's save it. And here under the survey group, we can now see, okay, he is a member of NEPO and the Wednesday Academy group. So we have a group, we have a user attached to that group. Let's assign some surveys to that group too. So we go to surveys, survey list. Let's pick the two surveys that we worked on last week for the API Academy. Those are those two. Open them, set up. And if we then go to the general tab, you will see survey group here again. This one has been assigned to the default group. I can open it, and now decide I assign this one to the Wednesday Academy group. As you can see, I can only assign surveys to one group. Save this one. Let's go back to surveys. And also assign the second one to the same survey group, Wednesday Academy. That's it. And then we're done. We have created a group. We have created a user. We have assigned that user to that group. We have assigned two surveys to that group. So we can now log off and sign out. Sign in again, and this time as the user we just created. So that was Test Academy Wednesday. Password I copied using sign in here. It's a new user, so I need to change that password. First the old password, and then I'm going to copy and paste my new password. So I'm sure we don't make any mistakes. Change password. And there we are. We are signed in as the test user. Test user has been assigned to the Wednesday Academy group. Those are the two surveys that test user sees. He has been assigned to NEPO. There is only one survey currently in the NEPO group, and that is the survey he sees also. So this works fine. One more thing to show here to take into consideration. If I now start creating a survey as this user, as you can see, here is the survey group. It will be placed in a survey group default in the first group of the list, and this survey, because he is assigned to only NEPO and the Wednesday Academy, can only assign surveys to one of these two groups, not to any other groups. So a user can only assign surveys to the group he is a member of. That makes sense. This is also the reason why every user is placed in the default group at start, because if he wasn't placed in any group, he couldn't create any server at all, any survey at all. So that is for our user. Now, one last thing to take a look at. Let's again log off as this user, sign out, and sign in as the DA again. Let's go back to that group, to that list of groups, after the survey list has been loaded. Let's now say, okay, I'm done with this test. I want to delete this group. As you can see, I cannot delete this group, and I cannot delete this group because there are still surveys assigned to this group. If I want to delete this group, I need to go to surveys again. This time say only show the favorite surveys, because those are the two surveys that I have assigned to. Or maybe let's not do it. Let's not do it this way. Let's not choose the favorites. Let's actually, one last thing to point out. You can see, as I said, which surveys are assigned to what group here in this list survey group. So if I want to know, okay, which surveys are actually still assigned to the Wednesday Academy, I can add a filter. I can say survey group, and then say contains Wednesday Academy. No, that's not what we want. Wednesday Academy. Confirm that filter, and it shows the all the surveys assigned to Wednesday Academy. As we know, that are just two. So I can go to setup, then assign this to the default group again, save it, back to the survey list. rather back to my search result, which will now only show one survey. Let's also unassign that and assign it to the default again. And if we go back, our search, our search results should be empty. There are no more surveys in the survey group Wednesday Academy. So we can now go into groups, open Wednesday Academies, and now we can actually delete this group, which we will do. Okay, that's all of for the demo. Let's go back to our presentation. No idea why it is doing, why it isn't doing this anymore. Anyway, now recap. Users with DA rights, as you can see, will always see all surveys. So make sure that you use the DA only for people that really are administrating your domain. Because otherwise those groups will not work. Those users will always see all group, will always see all surveys. Users can be assigned to multiple groups, but surveys can only be assigned to one group. New users are assigned to the default group. New surveys are assigned to the first group in the list that the creator is a member of. If you weren't using groups before, all your surveys are currently assigned to the default group. Users must be actively unassigned from the default group if you do not want them to have access to that group. Users not assigned to any group cannot create new surveys, so make sure that your users are assigned to at least one group unless you explicitly want a user that is a regular user but cannot do anything on the survey. As you can see, you cannot delete the default group, and you cannot delete a group if surveys are still assigned to that group. That was it. Any questions, Art?
No, Frank, all's clear, no questions.
Good, I like it when all is clear. So, final remarks. Recording of the session, as always, will be available later this week. This feature, including everything that I show you, was on the live survey. So all of this is live. One thing you need to keep in the back of your mind, we are still working on that user tab for the single sign-on. The single sign-on has what we call security groups. We will make it possible that you can use that group to, that you can assign an entire group to a assign a entire survey group to a entire security group to a survey group, many times the word group. That will become available one of the coming weeks. Otherwise, everything works for the single sign-on users as well. Manuals are already updated. If you have suggestions for a topic, please write to your help desk. And next week, last academy in our spring session, how to start surveys. That's it. If there are no last questions, this was it. Thank you, and talk to you next week. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you for joining. Bye-bye.